Hi guys and welcome back to the channel. So in today's video we're carrying on with the Master Universe haul that I've got from America. And we have got another one of the deluxe figures. It's one of the deluxe figures released from wave number two. So as I turn around the box, you can see the figures in the wave. And actually, it's just confusing me here because according to my list, this is wave number two. However, it's pretty much up with wave number three. So the two figures that I thought came with wave number two, I'm probably still going to display them there because they do slide into wave number three, was Savage He-Man and Faker. We've already unboxed the Triclops, which is what I thought was the Series 3 figure. And then we've got the other ones in the range, Scareglow and Stinker. Upcoming, I have got Fisto and Andra, which will just complete that range apart from Faker. But I am going to pop this Savage He-Man with the with Wave 2, because I did think it was going there and I've made space for it there. So let's have a little read of it. For years it was assumed that Prince Adam could only call upon the power of Grayskull using the Sword of Power. But what happens if he did not rise aloft his magic sword and still said, by the power of Grayskull? The answer? Savage He-Man, a combination of primal rage and all the power of the universe. He-Man tears through Eternia in an uncontrolled rampage, leaving his friends hoping that Adam is in there somewhere. So, there you see Savage He-Man on the back. We'll look at him in box. See, this, to be fair, this is pretty much a bit of an amalgamation of a box. So you got Savage He-Man. In the series, it was just Savage He-Man. He had no weaponry. It was just literally his bare hands. But I think just to fill out this deluxe box, they've added a sort of power and an axe. Not needed. And they've also included Orko. Now, also, at this point in the series, Orko wasn't associated with Savage He-Man. So I just think this is a bit of an amalgamation of a box, in all honesty. But I'm glad to have an Orko figure and I'm glad to have a Savage He-Man figure. So we will have a look at the two figures. I'm not going to add any of the accessories to these two figures because it's just a poor representation of them. So we will get them out of the box and see how they look. So, hopefully Orko comes straight out. We have got the elastic bands keeping Orko in as well. Bit too tight, if you ask me. So we'll look at Orko first, who comes. He is very nicely mounted on a flight stand. So you've got Orko with his blue arms and his purple sort of face mask and scarf going all the way down his back. His usual red hat with his ears poking out the sides. And obviously his yellow googly eyes you can see looking forward. He will display very nicely in the collection on this little flight stand that they've mounted him on. And he is very poseable. So all in all, for an extra sort of figure in the box, very, very cool figure indeed. So really pleased with Orko. So we will get him added into the collection. So as I say, very, very happy with that one. And then on to the next figure. So as I say, Orko in the series at this point wasn't associated with Savage He-Man part of the series. I won't spoil the series because if you haven't seen it, it is well worth watching. But here is Savage He-Man. So it is pretty much He-Man wearing nothing but his loincloth. Obviously, the hair is a lot longer and a lot wilder. Like I say, just with his brown loincloth. And then obviously the big feet. And then obviously the muscular toned body of He-Man. So this was He-Man basically without the power sword and without any of his weapons, just literally He-Man as he was as he was sort of just trying to fight back against Skelly God. As I say, this was just like literally the wild version of He-Man, Savage He-Man, for want of a better word. So not a lot else to write home about this figure. I think they could have included in this box, unfortunately they haven't, a bit more of a wilder face. He's just got this pretty sort of standard face on him. But the Savage He-Man from the series is very much a rage monster. Just seething out with anger, ready to rip anything in his path apart. So that would have been nice, as sort of like just a more angrier face. This is very much a placid face that they've put on him. So you could have really done that with the figure and popped an angrier face on the figure. But otherwise, not too bad a figure at all. And we will go and add Savage He-Man and Orko to the collection. So there you can see Savage He-Man and Orko added in. As we look at the full sort of Wave 2 collection now, as I say, we have got Faker, the Deluxe Faker, to try and pick up at some point and add in there next to He-Man, the Savage version, that is. But nevertheless, does look a real sort of beastie figure. The Orko does look cool and the He-Man really does look good. But I just, like I say, I do wish, and as you can see with this, you can see the face a lot better in this mode. It would have just done with like a sort of a seething, sort of frothing at the mouth sort of face on that figure. But it does look a cool figure with the sort of savage looking He-Man. But as we look at the whole range as a whole, it is building into a brilliant collection. These deluxe figures are absolutely brilliant. The Man-at-Arms is fantastic, as is old Skelly God there at the back. Really pleased. Then hopefully we can start adding a few to the guys in the lower runs of the collection. We have got the next two figures of series 3 to unbox in the next few videos, so hopefully they'll come up soon. But all in all, we have got this Masterverse set starting to take shape. Before long, I will be having to move and relocate some of these Batmans and Justice League characters, but no qualms in doing that. I do think this Master Universe display I am putting together is very much worth it. But I'll leave you with this last look at the Savage He-Man and Orko into the collection and looking absolutely fantastic. Really pleased to have them both in the collection. So there you have it, Savage He-Man added into the collection and another one of the Masterverse figures ticked off in my collection. Like I say, I'm going to still look out for the Faker Deluxe figure. It is the next one I do need to continue finishing off the waves. But I have got a couple of the figures from Wave 3 to start getting that boxed off. As I say, we've already seen the Deluxe Triclops get unboxed, along with Scareglow and Stinkar. So it just leaves Andra and Fisto to unbox in that wave, and we do have them actually in hand now, so we will be getting onto them very, very shortly indeed. As I always say in the comments, let me know what you think to Savage He-Man. As I say, I like the figure and I like the I think they could have done a lot more with the face. Obviously, like I say, really wanted it to be much more of a sort of seething face. It's pretty much a placid face they've got on it. And for the character he was in the series, the anger and the rage just doesn't sort of show in the face of the figure. Otherwise, the body sculpt and the hands and the legs does look very much representative of the character. And the Orko figure, very much a very cool figure indeed. Obviously, you need an Orko in any Master Universe set. I do still think there will be a second Orko figure introduced. I'm not going to say too much about that, but obviously, if you have seen the Master Universe Revelations figure, you'll know what I'm talking about. Otherwise, if you haven't previously, please subscribe to the channel. I appreciate every single one of you who does take the time to do so. Otherwise, that is it for today. I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.